Ladies and gentlemen, silence please. The following film documents the making of And Then There Were None, a play put together by the Stirling University Drama Society, based on Agatha Christie's original murder mystery. Prepare to go behind the scenes as director Freya Stevenson and Teddy Finlow, alongside their excellent cast, crew and producer Maisie Peary, craft an impressive work of theatre that will no doubt go down in history as one of the best student productions of this particular play at this particular university. No detail has been spared, no stone left unturned. Prisoners at the bar, sit back, relax, and enjoy the show.
I'm Teddy.
I'm Freya.
And I'm Maisie.
And we are the Power Rangers.
co-director, producer of...
And then there were none!
It was my idea to co-direct with Teddy, which was a great idea.
I think we both have quite similar ideas for it, and it's really good that... not to toot our own horns, but to have two perspectives, I think there's less stuff that we'll miss and more that we'll pick up, and kind of to make the play better to each of our visions, because we've got a vision.
But Teddy, we both work very differently. I'm quite manic when I get into it, and I don't really. Teddy's quite a perfectionist, so he. Make sure everything's done correctly, and then I think my manic side makes sure that we get it done on time. So I think we're a very good team.
We both have quite different work styles, and I think I take it a bit too slow sometimes. I'm very thorough, but Freya's really the clockwork behind it, which is very good.
There are two of my best friends, which is obviously a good thing. I feel like we get on very well, and it's just very easy. And I've thoroughly enjoyed it so far.
I was in a bit of a funk because I wasn't really enjoying uni, and I really wanted to just get out and do something, so I was speaking to my family about it, and my brother's always very overachieving, and he was like, well, you should just write your own play and direct it, and I was like, easier said than done, Callum.
Freya came up with it first, and she was like, she wants to do a play, and she wanted me to co-direct it with her, but we hadn't had an idea for the play yet. So then I suggested The Mousetrap, because I went to see it with my aunt one time and I really enjoyed it. It was one of the first plays I saw, I think. Pretty sure. I said that in the pitch anyway. So we decided to do The Mousetrap, and then we got Maisie Peary to produce, and it all went from there.
Basically, what happened was we were dead set with Mousetrap. We were quite close to auditions at this point. We'd picked a few audition scenes that we knew we wanted to do. And then we checked on the website, and the rights were no longer available because it's their 75th anniversary this year, so you can't put on any performances. So that was very... I remember the moment, because I was meant to be doing an essay, and then it was just pure panic. But Franco calmed us down and it was all fine.
I think it was very lenient, very nice, very kind that we were able to quickly change the play to another Agatha Christie murder mystery, which is what we wanted to do, and it's basically what we pitched. And, well, now we're doing And Then There Were None. So, the play is about 10 strangers who are invited to Soldier Island. Under false pretenses, we find out. So these 10 strangers are all very individual, intriguing characters, all with a very developed, interesting backstory. All of them are murderers, which is funny for a murder mystery, because I mean, who's the big murderer?
I really like its very dark theme. I think it makes it very exciting. But it also has some comedic moments as well, especially at the start with each kind of character. And I do like that each character has their own quirks, and it's a play where if you're cast in it, you were always going to be cast in an interesting role, which I think is quite a special thing. I've never been in a play like that myself, so I think it's a very unique play.
My name is Em. I'm 19. I studied geography teaching because I'm cool, and I play Vera Claythorne in the play.
I'm Maddie Dow, and I am playing Sir Lawrence Walgrave in And Then There Were None.
I'm Zaria. I'm a first year, and I'm playing Ethel Rogers.
So hi, my name is Edward MacMillan, and I'm playing the role of Sergeant McKenzie in the play And Then There Were None.
Hi, I'm Franco, and I am playing William Bloor.
My name is Davis.
My name is Shani, and I play Philip Lombard.
I am Melissa Malcolm, and I play Dr. Edward Armstrong.
My name is Christian O'Neill. I play Thomas Rogers in the play And Then There Were None.
Hello, I'm Callan Cowney, and I'm going to be playing The Voice in Agatha Christie's And Then There Were None.
I'm Ruby. I'm playing Emily Brent in And Then There Were None.
Hi, my name is Des, and I'm playing Anthony Marston in And Then There Were None.
My name is Paul Kelly, and I'm playing Fred Narragott.
You at least look happy.
Just how did the audition go?
I skinned one of my elbows, I bled on the carpet, and then in the day for callbacks, I did it again. Blood was shed. I'm really glad I got the part after that.
I really enjoyed the auditions, actually. I got to audition with a few people I haven't auditioned with before, which was really nice. Look at you.
Yeah.
And I distinctly remember during the auditions, they gave me the Walgrave monologue, and then in the first night, and then the second night callbacks, they gave it to me again. And it was that time I was kind of like, oh, okay. I think I've done quite well with this monologue.
I didn't read for Fred, but Teddy asked me to do like different accents and stuff, so I guess that's why I got this part, because this character is meant to have like a Devon accent.
Can you show us your Devon accent?
No.
I auditioned for Mrs. Rogers, which was quite fun. Me and Cowney played Mr. and Mrs. Rogers, so that would have been quite fun to get my teeth into, but to be honest, I think Emily Brent is one of the nastiest characters. So again, it's always just really fun to play those kind of psychopathic characters.
The audition went really well initially. Admittedly, a lot of the characters that I auditioned for weren't actually the one that I ended up getting, but I did have Sergeant McKenzie as one of the ones I wanted to do anyway, so I'm quite happy with how it turned out.
It was very surreal to be thrust into a situation where you're put in the space that you have to audition straight away. I joined SUDS in a very unusual circumstance. I joined SUDS last year and only joined for a couple workshops. And then this year I wanted to fill a sort of void where I could have a social group and an environment where I'm able to be like creative and free. And so my first workshop was auditions. Which was kind of cool to be able to experience what auditions are like in a much more structured environment. In terms of audition, the night of the auditions, it was nice because it wasn't extremely daunting. I was like in a room with actors who were under the same sort of situation as me, trying to prepare themselves to give a good performance.
I was pretty drunk, so
not very Armstrong of you.
I can't really remember the audition. My heart was beating very, very fast, because very much out of my comfort zone. But everyone was really supportive, which made it really sweet, and clearly people liked what they saw.
It was fun. It was a lot of fun. it was nice because it was my first audition this year, because I did an audition for Passing Places. And we made a lot of fun choices in certain scenes that I'm very disappointed weren't filmed. But we had some fun. We had some fun. We've also ruined a few scenes for the team.
It went pretty well. I mostly only auditioned for Philip, so I had a hint that if I was going to get casted, it was probably for Philip.
I did a video audition, which was fine. Not anything I'm not used to, so that was fine. I had my girlfriend read it for me, which was nice. And then the second night was quite fun because it got to actually have like other people audition with. But I knew from the beginning that I wanted to go for Anthony Marston, so it was good to have like the chance to read that several times because they let me. Well, they let me try it. Clearly they liked what they saw, so.
I think it really went well. I mean, there was like an added pressure because it was like, I was meeting everyone for the first time, but everyone was really lovely and I really liked the process. I was super nervous and I was also ill during it though. So like my heart was racing from anxiety and the illness, but yeah, it was really fun.
I was incredibly impressed by the turnout.
Yeah, it was a lot.
I thought it was very lovely to see so many people were interested in being in our play.
A bit more than we bargained for, I think, because I kind of went into a manic mode, because I think next time we decided we were gonna kind of pre-arrange who wanted to audition for what, because we kind of sat there after we said hello to everybody, we were like, we have to give everybody two different auditions of our choosing, because everybody wrote down, oh, I'll audition for everything. So, yeah. But there was loads of talent, wasn't there?
And it was a lot of fun.
There was lots of talent, wasn't there?
Yes, there was a lot of talent.
it was very... I like the feeling of sitting behind the desk.
Powerful.
I felt very, very powerful, very important.
So the first scene we're going to do starts on page, top of page 11.
How are you? Davis. Davis is the name. What was it?
That's right. So much to do, I don't know where to start. No maids till the morning and all these guests arriving today.
Yeah, rehearsals are going well. I think we're ahead of our schedule right now. I don't know how long that'll last.
Each to say, you, N, Owen.
It's going very quickly.
Yeah, the rehearsals go really quickly.
It was very easy to block.
Because there's no...
It's just been a bunch of movement.
Yeah, there's not a lot of stopping and starting, so it's a really smooth play that rehearses really quickly.
I'm afraid our host and hostess haven't arrived, sir. My name's Lombard.
Rehearsals are going really well. I'm having a lot of fun because I feel like usually so far in time we haven't blocked as many scenes as we have now, so it's quite impressive, and I think it's because it's all in one set, but I like how smooth it's going.
Cat's out of the bag, it seems. I best admit my name isn't David.
It's weird, there's like this level of camaraderie within the cast, and everyone in the cast seems to know what each person wants to do. But like their characters, and everyone's like kind of just doing it. Normally there's a level of like, oh, I'm not sure what to do, or like people finding themselves like really lost.
To be able to move and interact and see each actor's expressions, their responses, is very important, because you get to read and play off of each other a lot easier than just sitting down and, you know, reading lines.
One little soldier boy left all alone. He went and hanged himself, and then there were none.
What I've really enjoyed most about like this is like being able to spend so much time on everyone's individual character and their individual moments, and I think we've really been able to focus on that, which should come across in the play.
That dirty old double-crosser! He's let me down. Well, it is a pretty wizard island. Rather a wizard girl, that secretary. She has a
lie. I love acting with Des. I like the little fight Lombard and Marston have going on. It's very fun to play.
Perhaps it was her husband's fault.
She hasn't got a husband!
I think Ruby is a really standout in, as an actor. I think she's really, really excelled in this role that she's doing.
Yeah.
I think the dedication she shows to the role and to learning lines is just exceptional.
Yeah, and she's fully embodied the character, even like, I'll look over and she'll never
relax, even in rehearsals. Like, she's always in, like, the character.
You were footling in the middle of the road! Footling! Me footling!
How about a drink, huh?
I'm very confident so far. I'm very confident in the ability of the actors
so
and in getting through the script.
When we were actors, like especially me, I would get really nervous.
Yeah.
But right now I'm chill because I know at the end of the day we don't have to get on stage. No, I'm confident in, I would be shitting it if I wasn't confident in the actors, but we're so confident in them that
yeah,
I know it'll go well, really well.
Welcome to the cottage. This is Sud's room. It's a mess, but this is where we keep all of our set and our props. Something that we need to tidy up and go through and fix.
The cottage is a bit crazy, but
cottage.
In a good way because it made it more fun to hunt through things. One day we will tidy it though. I quite fancy doing that because I feel like it would be very satisfying. Don't hold me to that. But we did find a lot, actually a huge amount. So I think there's been many plays that are in a similar time frame, so there's loads of stuff. I think pretty
lots
much
of suits,
we've
dresses.
Got loads and loads of things already. We don't need to buy much, which is very good as our budget is slowly going. Fastly going, quickly going.
Yeah.
We maybe left the set a little bit too late.
Yeah.
But we've done it. It's
yeah.
We
made it out of plywood, in with a few days to spare as well.
Yeah, but
lots of painting.
George is our set designer, and she's been really great at
visualizing
it. And I don't think I could have done it.
Okay, guys, this is the set. You're seeing it before anyone else. An imagined version.
What ideas have you had for the set?
You can't ask me that because. I didn't.
Just say you called up your dad to make a window.
Oh yeah, so true. I actually did call my dad.
Dode.
That man has a lot of wood.
There were so many elements we forgot about, like we totally forgot we had to do a photo shoot for the poster.
Yeah.
And that was the most stressful night we had, was trying to figure out when we could get that done. But we got it done so quickly and easily.
We got to make sure we have every single piece of costume that we
and
need.
Prop.
And prop. That's other people's problems though. We've got a costume department, we've got a prop department, not our problem.
Yeah.
Ish.
Yeah. I do tend to take everything on. Because I'm a bit pernickety.
Yeah.
So I like to do everything myself.
I think one of my main concerns coming into the play was how many tickets we'd sell and if it would be up to the standard that Suds has done in previous shows.
Because I didn't think this play would grab that many people's attention.
Mm.
We've not even flyered, we've not printed off any posters, which we probably actually should have.
But like, we didn't need to. By that time that we had them, it was already sold out.
I don't know how it has, because. I'm quite glad because flyering is my least favourite thing.
Have a big ego when it comes to plating. But what you might not know is the backstage crew have an even bigger ego. Hi, my name is Ian Mayfield, and I'm one of the backstage boys for And Then There Were None. I'm joined today by my very special friend,
Kieran Sweeney. Am I in this?
Yeah, you're in this.
Okay, nice.
And up there are two fucking assholes called
Darren and Andrew.
Hi, Kale! Hi, Kale! Fuck you, Ian! Hi, Kale!
Well, I guess we're doing a tour?
Yeah, we're doing a little tour. Come on, let's have a look. So, what our job entails, for mostly because there's no set changes,
is we got to do a lot of the prop stuff.
Because this is our only time to be on stage.
And it includes such exciting things as turning lights on and off, like this.
Or like this. Oh shit, did I break it?
Or going over here and taking off the soldiers whenever people die. And you hide them in a box behind there, but you don't need to see all that. No, this way, come this way. Now we go this way, to the actual backstage. Come on.
There you go, Franco. Go cry into the microphone.
Fuck up. Now we've got the props table, which is right here.
Backstage manager.
Hi.
I don't do much, so you're not doing a good job of it.
Yeah, so there's all the props in the play, there's the record and the noose and the hats and the everything, really.
There's a gun, but that always, someone's always playing with it.
Dude,
it's just a hallway.
There's too many other hallways, okay, Kieran?
Thank you.
Some stairs. There's a Kieran.
I took a shit.
Now what we're about to enter is the dressing rooms. So get some behind the scenes. Look, there's the directors.
Hi.
Hello.
And the Georgian.
I actually put a lot of work into this, Ian.
And that's why you have your own title as Georgian.
Are you driving?
Yes.
Can we use you after the show, please?
Yeah, that's fine.
Thank
you.
Excellent.
Thank you. Gotcha. And now we're going to go and do something very sneaky. We're going to go look in the dressing room. I hope nobody's getting changed.
Ian, stop it!
Yes, everyone's getting changed and ready for the show. You can all be funny, I guess.
Sorry.
Where's Michael?
Oh,
yeah, he's
about,
isn't
he?
Bitch. Pacing like his character.
Thank goodness I didn't make souffle.
It's not me, it's definitely Maddie, right? It's not me.
True.
Like star-wise, it's not me. Just forgot I had a coat on until like right now, so it's going well so far. Unmedicated, unfiltered.
Very excited. I'm glad it's the last one. I wish we could do it for more than 2 days. I have my revolver.
I'm telling you, it's the ball.
Hopefully, we won't get stuck this time. Were you there yesterday?
I was, yeah.
Have it.
You improv quite well, you and M.
It's there. Give me a minute.
I'm Ellie, I do the hair, and I don't ever want to do it again.
Ellie's doing the makeup for the bullet wound in Wargrave's head with me, Ian Bayfield. Look out for it.
Yeah.
Oh, good one, Kelly. Thank you.
Do you come from Varsity?
I come from this.
We have now set will be adequate.
I have wanted to take love.
We just want to say thank you all so much. This has been amazing and we've enjoyed it so much. And we want to give you guys a little something.
And all of the cast will be getting a little soldier from the set.
Hey.
Oh, but apart from we have separate things for you guys. Because there's only 10.
Last question, how are you going to celebrate after the play is finally over?
We're going to have a massive afters. We're going to get so drunk.